Greetings, people of Earth. I'm Rick Harold. Thanks again for listening to my video and podcasts. Today we're talking about the Lambda function. Now, the Lambda function is a term that Amazon uses on their AWS server structure. It's about 2.5 years old, but it's probably one of the coolest things I think that was created, certainly in the cloud community, but just in general. The Lambda function represents a singular function of limited capacity that you're able to run code on. But the beautiful part about it is the way Amazon and also Microsoft and Google have supported in their own way, is that you have a super scalable function that, given a particular ability, let's say compressing an image, you're able to then scale it up to into the millions effectively with almost no effort on our developer point of view. That Amazon, Microsoft, and Google take care of the heavy lifting there. But it goes way beyond that. This Lambda function, by the nature of a structure, creates a limited functionality. And why is that good? Well, that's good because you don't want to create a monolithic giant function with too many operations that you're doing in there. You want to keep it small, much like you do with a C++ or Java code in terms of your class structure. And it keeps it very singular. That allows you to create a clear definition of it. That allows you to be able to version it easily. It allows you to be able to chain these together and to be able to create various units that work in conjunction with each other. They don't even necessarily have to be geographically connected, although they'll create latency based on their distance and where they happen to be. But from a software point of view, especially when you look at Teams, the Lambda function really kind of forces what the C++ class abstraction and object-oriented programming did many years ago, physically in terms of its abilities and how you implement it. So when Amazon came out with this 2.5 years ago, it was like super cool. And it's even more so today. And as time goes on, because you can create bigger products using multiple Lambda functions, you don't have to worry about the cloud structure, the machines that you're running on, because it's completely abstracted away from you, both from scale and redundancy. We've had some Lambda functions running literally for 2 years. And other than versioning updating, if you want to update what they're doing, there's almost nothing to do. Even maintaining machines themselves in the cloud, whether they're containers or not, takes more effort. And because of the nature of containers and machines, you can put more stuff on them, which for new products is what you don't want to have to do. So I wanted to point out the fact that this Lambda function is, it's really kind of revolutionary. And it's something that we almost exclusively use in terms of our server structure because of the various aspects that I already mentioned. So I appreciate you watching the video, and check out the Lambda function. Take it easy.